In this video, let's see how to implement single sign-on in Angular. This tutorial will be using the configuration from this Git repository. You can find the GitHub link in this video's description. Single sign-on is based on OAuth2 and OpenID Connect. Let's create a simple single sign-on Angular app. Open Visual Studio Code or any other IDE. We will open a folder for keeping the project. Now open a new terminal from Terminal Menu, New Terminal. Create an Angular app sso-app by typing the command ng-new sso-app. Press Y and hit Enter to enable routing in Angular. Select CSS as the stylesheet format and hit Enter. It will take some time to set up the new Angular project. Now the Angular project is set up. You can see the project structure in the Explore section of Visual Studio Code. Let's install the OAuth2 OIDC package for Angular. For that, change the current working directory to project folder. Type cd sso-app in the terminal. Now type npm install angular oauth2 oidc-save in the terminal. Once the installation is completed, type ng-serve-open to run the Angular application. On successful compilation, the application will open in the browser. This is the default Angular application template. Let's change it. Inside the app folder of the Angular application, you can find appcomponent.html file. Open it. Accept the router outlet tag, delete everything else. Because Angular routing happens in the router outlet. Now we will add a div tag with two buttons inside it. One for login and another for logout. It will look like this. Set click events. So that, on clicking these buttons, we will call the login and logout functions. We must define these functions inside the app.component.ts file. Now, let's create an Angular component home, which should be displayed on successful login. For that, open a new terminal. Change current working directory and type ng-generate component home. You can see the component created under the app folder. Now let's add URL routing for this component. Open the app routing module.ts file. In the routes variable, add path home. Set the component as home component. Save the file. Let's try it out. It's working. Also, we will add default route path, which takes care of all invalid URL paths. We will redirect it to home component. Save the file. That's working fine. For the Angular application to work properly, we must include the components and import required modules in the app.module.ts file. Let's do it. At the top of the file, import required items. Add OAuth module for root inside the imports array. Add the home component inside the declarations array. Now we need to create a configuration file for OAuth2. Create a file named sso.config.ts. Inside the app folder, we will copy-paste the configuration from GitHub repo mentioned earlier. Since we do not have any single sign-on server, now, add a constructor in the appComponent.ts file. And inject the OAuth service. Create a function configure single sign-on for configuring OAuth service variable. Inside the function, first we will call configure. As a parameter, we should pass the configuration defined earlier in the sso.config.ts file. Next, we will set a token validator. For that, built-in validator JWKS validation handler can be used. Lastly, call the method loadDiscoveryDocument and tryLogin. These methods must be invoked while the component is being created. So, call the function configure single sign-on inside the constructor. Inside the login function, call the method initImplicitFlow. And inside the logout function, call the method logout. Save the file. Let's test it. Open browser and click on login button. You can use the username as Max and password as GEHEIM. Now let's click on logout button. It's working. Now, we will display the home component only if the user logs in. For that, we will create a getAccessor function token. Let's create a variable claims for storing claims from the token. Using the function getIdentityClaims, if the login was successful, we will return the claims. Else we'll return null. Now call this getAccessor function in the ngif of router outlet, so that the home component is loaded only on successful login. Let's check it out. Yes, it's working. Now let's modify the home component. Open home.component.html file. We will add some login success message here. Save the file. Let's run the application again and see. Also, we can set the visibility of buttons based on the login status. Just set the ngif for login and logout buttons, like this. This looks fine. Sometimes we need the application to take us to the login page automatically, without clicking any button. Let's do that. First, we will delete the login and logout buttons. and its associated functions. All we have to do is replace the function call loadDiscoveryDocument and trylogin with function loadDiscoveryDocument and login. Save the file and open the application. We are redirected to the login page automatically, without clicking any button. That's it. Thanks for watching.